Hi, Ram children. So, welcome English new voices. And children, today we are going to continue with chapter 6, Wind on the Hill. Right? I hope you all remember last week we started with chapter 6, Wind on the Hill. Yes, today we are going to continue with that. I hope you all have learned the poem. Or started learning the poem at least, and you all must have understood it also. Okay, so today once again we're going to recite the poem and then we will have a look at the questions and answers. Okay, we'll understand how an answer has to be given to the question. So let's start. Chapter 6, Wind on the Hill, written by A.A. Milne. Okay. No one can tell me, nobody knows where the wind comes from, where the wind goes. It's flying from somewhere as fast as it can. I couldn't keep up with it, not if I ran. Keep up with it means to match the speed with. Yes? But if I stopped holding the spring of my kite, it would blow with the wind for a day and a night. And then when I found it, wherever it blew, I should know that the wind had been going there too. So then I could tell them where the wind goes, but where the wind comes from, nobody knows. Yes? So children, this poem is about wind. And a small boy in the poem, he is very curious to know the nature of the wind, the whereabouts of the wind. That means he wants to know where is this wind coming from and where is the wind going. What is the nature of this wind? And he says, nobody knows because nobody is able to give him an answer. So he says, nobody can tell me and nobody knows from where the wind is coming and where the wind is going. And he says, if at all I leave the string of my kite, then the kite will blow with the wind. And if later on I find my kite, then I will know that the wind was going there. That is the reason it has taken my kite there and I found it there. Right? So he says, only if I leave the spring of my kite and it blows with the wind and later on when I find it, can I tell that the wind was blowing there. But from where the wind is coming, he says, nobody knows about it and nobody can tell me about it. Okay? So let us recite this poem once again. Yes, chapter 6, Wind on the Hill, written by A.A. Milne. No one can tell me, nobody knows where the wind comes from, where the wind goes. It's flying from somewhere as fast as it can. I couldn't keep up with it, not if I ran. But if I stopped holding the string of my kite, it would blow with the wind for a day and a night. And then when I found it, wherever it blew, I should know that the wind had been going there too. So then I could tell them where the wind goes, but where the wind comes from, nobody knows. Yes, children, I hope this is clear. The little boy is saying that he wants to know from where the wind is coming, where the wind is going, but nobody is able to give him an answer to this. And he's saying the wind is so fast that he is not able to match the speed with the wind even if he runs. So even if he runs along with the wind, he is not able to match the speed. So the wind is that fast. And he says the only way I can find out is if I leave the string of my kite, then the kite would blow with the wind and later on when I find the kite, I will know that the wind was going there. But from where the wind is coming, he says nobody knows and nobody is able to give me an answer. Okay, so children, I hope this poem is very clear to you all. Yes, and again, a reminder that you all have to learn this poem for the recitation. Now, let us see the questions that come up. Answer these questions with reference to the context. Yes, some lines from the poem I mentioned over here. You have to answer the questions asked here based on the lines given. Okay. No one can tell me. Nobody knows. Who is the speaker here? Who's saying these lines? No one can tell me. Nobody knows. Yes. Yes. The little boy. The speaker here is a child, right? The little child. He is a speaker here. So they are asking, who is the speaker here? That means who has said these lines? So the speaker here is a child. Okay. Let's go to the next question. What does the speaker want to know? What does the speaker want to know? Yes. What does the little child want to know? He wants to know. The speaker wants to know where the wind comes from and where the wind goes. Isn't it? What does he want to know? He wants to know where the wind comes from and where the wind goes. So the answer will be, the speaker wants to know where the wind comes from and where the wind goes. Dear children, let's see the next question. By the end of the poem, does the speaker get an answer? By the end of the poem, does the speaker get an answer? What was his question? Where does the wind come from and where it goes? So by the end of the poem, does he get an answer to this? No, the speaker does not get an answer by the end of the poem. Yes? The answer to this is no, the speaker does not get an answer by the end of the poem. Clear, children? Now let's go to the next one. Now again, we have taken two lines from the poem. It would blow with the wind for a day and a night. It would blow with the wind for a day and a night. Okay? Now again, who is the speaker here? Who has said these lines? Yes, the speaker here is a child. Right? Again, the speaker here is a child. What would blow with the wind? What would blow with the wind? The kite will blow with the wind. Yes? What would blow with the wind? What does he say it will blow with the wind? The kite, isn't it? The kite will blow with the wind. He says, if I lay the string of my kite, it will blow with the wind. Yes? So the answer to this question is, the kite will blow with the wind. Why would the thing blow with the wind? Why would the thing blow with the wind? Why will the kite blow with the wind? Yes, the child says that the kite would blow with the wind if he lets go of its string. Isn't it? He says that the kite would blow with the wind if he lets go of its string. So what does the child say? That if I leave the string of the kite will blow with the wind. So that is the answer to this question. Why would the thing blow with the wind? The child says that the kite would blow with the wind if he lets go of its string. Now the next, answer these questions. Okay. Now there are questions here and we are going to find answers to these questions. Why can no one tell where the wind comes from? Why can no one tell where the wind comes from? Yes, the answer to this is, no one can tell where the wind comes from because it is not visible. It can only be felt, isn't it? We saw it in the beginning, in the last class we had seen that we cannot see air. And what is wind? Fast moving air is called wind. So can we see wind? No, we cannot see it, but we can feel it. So the answer is, no one can tell where the wind comes from because it is not visible. It can only be felt. Okay? No one can tell where the wind comes from because it is not visible. It can only be felt. Let's see the next question. Why can't the child keep up with the wind? why can't the child keep up with the wind? So the answer is, the child cannot keep up with the wind because it's blowing very fast. Isn't it? We saw in the poem that the wind is so fast that even if the child ran along with it, he is not able to keep up with it. He is not able to match the speed of the wind. Okay? So the answer is, the child cannot keep up with the wind because it's blowing very fast. The child cannot keep up with the wind because it's blowing very fast. Okay. Now, children, we have choose the correct answer. Okay. We have a fill in the blank. We have options given. That means answers are given to us. We just have to select the correct answer. Okay. You have read the poem now. You have understood it well. So now you will be able to give me the correct answer for this. Okay. So let's read this. The child in the poem wants to know. The child in the poem wants to know. They are given us four options. Okay. So let's find out which is the correct one. A is why the wind blows. B is where the wind goes. C is where the wind comes from. Or option D is both B and C. So which is the correct one? B and C means where the wind goes and where the wind comes from. So what is it that the child wants to know? Yes, the child wants to know where the wind goes and where the wind comes from, right? Both he wants to know. So the correct answer would be B and C. Yes, so the correct answer is option D, both B and C. Understood, children? The child in the poem wants to know where the wind goes. He also wants to know where the wind comes from, right? So the correct option will be what? Option D, both B and C. Let's see the next one. The child dash. Now let's see the options here. A is can run as fast as the wind. B is can see the wind. C is can hold the wind. D is cannot run as fast as the wind. Which is the correct answer? The child, can he run as fast as the wind? No. Can he see the wind? No. Can he hold the wind? No. Cannot run as fast as the wind. Yes, this is the right answer. So the correct answer is option D. Cannot run as fast as the wind. The child cannot run as fast as the wind. Let's see the next one. The child gets to know where the wind goes to with the help of a dash. The child gets to know where the wind goes to with the help of a dash. Options are A, handkerchief, B, kite, C, weather vane, D, feather. Again, I'll repeat the options. A, handkerchief, B, kite, C, weather vane, D, feather. So what is it if the child leaves it, it goes with the wind and he comes to know that where the wind is going? What helps the child to know that? Yes, the option is B. Option B, kite. Right? The child gets to know where the wind goes to with the help of a kite. Understood, children? Let's see the next one. Which of the following statement best sums up the child's feelings towards the wind? Okay, what does the child feel towards the wind? That you're going to find the answer. Again, four options are given. And you're going to find out the correct option that tells us what the child feels towards the wind. Okay, the options are A, the child loves the wind. B, the child hates the wind. C, the child is scared of the wind. And D, the child is interested in the book. Okay, we read the poem, children. We understood what is there in the poem. Now, can you tell me from this poem, what do we come to know? What are the child's feelings towards the wind? The child loves the wind. The child hates the wind. The child is scared of the wind. Or the child is interested in the wind. Yes, the child is interested. He's curious to know about the wind, right? So option D, the child is interested in the wind, is the correct option. Dear children, I hope you all have understood this. I hope you all have understood the poem and the question answers that we discussed here right now. Yes. Now, children, remember one thing. You have to write these questions and answers in your English notebook. The PDF of the same will be sent to you. Okay. Some of the question answers, the PDF will be sent to you. So you all get write it in your English classwork notebook in a very neat handwriting. Whatever notes are being sent to you, children, you have to write it in your classwork notebook. I hope I'm clear. So let's stop here for today. Bye. Sai Ram.